From the Strip Studios, this is 10 News.
Hello, I'm Jim Patton with this 10 News update. A fire erupted at a mansion in Fairbanks Ranch last night. One witness we spoke to says he saw the flames shooting up in the air from miles away. There had been a cleaning crew inside the home when that fire started, but they all made it out safely. At one point, firefighters had to evacuate because the attic roof started to collapse. No one was hurt. Cause is under investigation. 10 News found the home on Zillow. It's listed at more than $10 million. Horrific tragedy in Paradise Hills over the weekend after a murder-suicide leaves five members of a family dead. 9-year-old boy is in the hospital now fighting for his life. Family members say that Sabrina Rosario was being harassed by her estranged husband, Jose Valdivia. She got a restraining order against him on Friday, just a day before the tragedy. Valdivia shot Sabrina and their four boys before killing himself. One boy survived and is in a medically induced coma. There is a GoFundMe for the family's funeral expenses, and we have a link on our 10 News site. Well, today, a last chance for residents to pitch ideas for the design of two public parks in Chula Vista. Harbor and Sweetwater Parks are part of the city's Bayfront redevelopment project. Two parks will account for more than half of the new park space planned in that project. One will be located just north of the marina and will wrap around the waterfront, and the other will be at the north end of the bayfront. Well, city officials are hoping to make progress today on the plan to sell the site of SDCCU Stadium to San Diego State University. Last month, San Diego State made a cash offer to the city of $68 million for the land. This is part of the voter-approved SDSU West project. However, the city is concerned over the timeline and how much the university is willing to cover as far as the costs. Today, the city council will be discussing how the city's negotiation team should move forward. Time now to get a check on our weather with drastic changes in store, right, Megan?
That's right. So another hot day today. Temperatures just a few degrees cooler than yesterday. Still about 10 to 20 degrees above normal, mostly in the low to mid 80s at the coast, mostly 90s inland, 70s in the mountains and near 90 in the deserts. Temperatures drop about 10 to 15 degrees tomorrow with another 10 to 15 degree drop by Wednesday as a storm moves in. Could see some showers as early as tomorrow afternoon with the brunt of the moisture coming through during the day on Wednesday. Spotty showers continuing on Thursday, though starting to taper off then. 80s today at the coast, 60s the rest of the week. For our inland neighborhoods, 90s today, mid-70s tomorrow, with mid-60s by Wednesday and Thursday. Jim?
Megan, thank you. And for the latest news, weather, and traffic, go to 10news.com or download our free 10 News app in your app store. For 10 News, I'm Jim Patton.